Was Jesus sent to be crucified? Audiobook by Faheem Judah-EL. The Universal Message. Sons of Sananda. The ancient and mystic order of IUM, head up, Jesus Christ. By Tjeti Faheem Judah-EL. Cover designed by Huram Heb, Ankh, Atum, Re. Was Jesus sent to be crucified? Published by Axum Publications 2014, Decatur, Illinois. All rights reserved. By Faheem Judah-EL. Sons of Sananda. Creed and Code of Conduct. What we know. Creed: in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. 2. The same was in the beginning with God. 3. All things were made by the Word, and without the Word was not anything made that was made. 4. In the Word was life, and the life was the light of men. 5. And the light shines in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. In the beginning was Atum, and Atum was with Nebuchadnezzar, and Atum was the Creator. 2. The same was in the beginning with Nebuchadnezzar. 3. All things were made by Atum, and without Atum was not anything made that were made. 4. In Atum was life, and the life was the light of men. 5. And the light shines in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Faheem Judah-EL, Tjeti, Translation. The Atum and the Word creation story are one and the same. Welcome to the Sons of Sananda, the Sons of Bliss. 7 Codes of Conduct. 1. You must cease desiring material things and learn to cherish spiritual knowledge. 2. You must exercise meditation, prayer, fasting, and the remembrance of the Creator. 3. You must apply your teachings and live the life you advocate. 4. You must protect children and give to the less fortunate. 5. You must always remember to ask, and it shall be given unto you. Seek and you shall find, knock and the door shall be opened unto you. 6. You must let meditation be your reflection and seek the space between your thoughts. 7. You must always speak the Ma-Karu from your true voice and execute all things with patience and constancy in all matters. Sons of Sananda, always speak the Ma-Karu. 1. One speech should be gentle and encouraging. 2. One is to listen patiently and indulgently, even when others are inarticulate and emotional in delivering their complaints. 3. One should strive to make others feel secure and satisfied. 4. One should avoid corruption and serve as a model for the masses and instruct with virtue. 5. One should refrain from giving false compliments. 6. One should tell the whole truth, there are no half lies. 7. One should speak with divine speech from who, divine, utterance to, Sia, divine, mind to, Heka, words of power. Thoughts and words are responsible for cause and effect. The 42 Divine Principles of Mat. 1. I have not committed sin. 2. I have not committed robbery with violence. 3. I have not stolen. 4. I have not slain men or women. 5. I have not stolen food. 6. I have not swindled offerings. 7. I have not stolen from Neter or Netert. 8. I have not told lies. 9. I have not carried away food. 10. I have not cursed. 11. I have not closed my ears to truth. 12. I have not committed adultery. 13. I have not made anyone cry. 14. I have not felt sorrow without reason. 15. I have not assaulted anyone. 16. I am not deceitful. 17. I have not stolen anyone's land. 18. I have not been an eavesdropper. 19. I have not falsely accused anyone. 20. I have not been angry without reason. 21. I have not seduced anyone's wife. 22. I have not polluted myself. 23. I have not terrorized anyone. 24. I have not disobeyed the law. 25. I have not been exclusively angry. 26. I have not cursed neither or neutered. 27. I have not behaved with violence. 28. I have not caused disruption of peace. 29. I have not acted hastily or without thought. 30. I have not overstepped my boundaries of concern. 31. I have not exaggerated my words when speaking. 32. I have not worked evil. 33. I have not used evil thoughts, words or deeds. 34. I have not polluted the water. 35. I have not spoken angrily or arrogantly. 36. I have not cursed anyone in thought, word, or deeds. 37. I have not placed myself on a pedestal. 38. I have not stolen what belongs to neither or neither. 39. I have not stolen from or disrespected the deceased. 40. I have not taken food from a child. 41. I have not acted with insolence. 42. I have not destroyed property belonging to neither or neither. Always speak the Ma Karu. Begin all things with the name of Igziabher the Most High. Ium Hadep. He has been called many names in many languages and many cultures. Roman, Jesus Christ. Hebrew, Yehoshua HaMoshiach. Greek, Horus. Babylonian, Tammuz. Galactical name, San Nanda. Egypt, Heru. Arabic, Isa, Ibn, Maryam. Modern Ethiopian Amharic, Iyesus. Introduction. It is very important for students of the Bible to understand that the version of the Bible that most people read is a canonized version of the adapted, original scriptures from ancient Kemet, with many apocryphal books left out, and other scriptures that many people have never heard of, such as the Qumran scrolls and the Gnostic writings. As these books were taken out of Kemet, Egypt, by the various Essene and Gnostic groups, and rewritten by the Jewish Sanhedrin and Greek writers, they were encrypted in symbols that had a higher spiritual meaning. These esoteric meanings were encrypted in stories, proverbs, psalms, and parables, and locked only to be deciphered by higher orders and secret societies. It is also important to note that the Catholic Bible has 72 books, and the Trinitarian Protestant Bible only has 66 books. Now, the Catholics say there are 73 books in the Bible, depending on whether Jeremiah and Lamentations are considered as one book or two. The Catholics view all other branches of Christianity as cults. The Catholic Bible. The only way for students today to truly understand the deeper meanings of the scriptures is to learn the meaning of the symbols. Jesus as a symbol. Jesus in one aspect is a symbol of the perfected man, and Christ is the spiritual essence of all men, but most human beings are not aware of their spiritual essence. John 1:9, that was the true light, which lights every man that comes into the world. You have to bear your own cross. Question: was Jesus sent into this world to be crucified? Answer: first we have to go to the origin or the source of this idea of crucifixion, or being sent into the world to be crucified. The origin of this verse comes from the 175th chapter of Pert M. Heru, in the chapter of not dying a second death. The Neteru is being addressed. Decree this, O tomb, a tomb ra, that if I behold thy face I shall not be pained by thy sufferings, this tomb decrees. The great Neter, tomb has given him Eusus, or Eum Hadet the supremacy, and he will reign on his throne in the Isle of Flame, for eternities of eternities. Chapter 175 of Pert Mhiru is the origin of Revelation 1:9-11. The first part of this verse is where God so loved the world, it comes from the pain of his suffering, it was taken from this verse. And called in the scriptures, the crucifixion of Christ, God being tomb, or a tomb ray, gives his saw, or son for humanity. He, symbolic of all of us, manifested into flesh, hydrogen 1, matter into the world, from ether spirit, John 1-9, that was the true light, which lighted every man that cometh into the world. Tomb or a tomb. Symbol of the Creator, divine consciousness, awakening, light. Question, what does crucifixion mean? Answer, first we must ask, what is a cross? The cross is a symbol of the crystallization of two currents of thought, the state of consciousness, termed sense-mind. This is the crossing of the animal self with the divine self. The vertical bar symbolizes the inner current of divine life. The horizontal bar symbolizes the cross current of human limitation. The horizontal symbolizes the mind of the flesh, also, and it burdens the body with its various erroneous beliefs. The center of action of the sense mind, set, is in the brain, and there it has to be met for the final crossing out. The I Am, or Christ consciousness, spiritual self must undertake this crossing out of the set, the sense man. This takes place in the place called the place of a skull. On this horizontal plane, Horus must battle set, the sense self. When we come into this world, we learn errors in our consciousness. These errors, known as the whole personality, must be wiped clean for resurrection to take place. Horus is the symbol of the Christ consciousness, spiritual man, the self, divine self, of ancient Kemet. Divine man versus sense man. The everyday battle between Hiru, divine, spirit man, Christ man, essence, and set, sense, animal self, flesh, opposition man, is a lifelong war. Crossing out of set, sense man. The cross represents the two currents of thought. The vertical bar symbolizes the inner current of divine life, that which is overcoming, or moving up, and the horizontal bar symbolizes the cross current of human limitation. The horizontal bar symbolizes the mind of the flesh, which burdens the body with its various erroneous beliefs. The horizontal bar must be crossed out by the Hiru or Christ man. It is the divine man that is becoming, or moving up in divine life. Question, so are you saying Jesus was not really crucified? Answer, I am saying this is the original meaning of what the symbol of crucifixion means. In the canon story, Jesus is sent into the world as a sacrifice, but there are problems in the story without gnosis. The story has problems if taken literal, and if you don't know the difference between the crucifixion of Christ the Word, and the crucifixion of Jesus the total personality, it can be very confusing to the soul. I will explain that in further detail later. When we are children, we begin to pick up errors in our consciousness. By the time we become adults, these errors become fixed states of mind. Crucifixion is a symbol of crossing out in consciousness the errors that have become fixed states of mind, the surrender or death of the whole personality in order that the Christ Hiru spirit mind may be expressed in all its fullness. Horus, Iesu's symbol of the spirit man, the Christ man, the Hiru. Question, so you are saying there is a difference between the crucifixion of Jesus and the crucifixion of Christ? Answer, yes, the crucifixion of Jesus, the perfected man, or the total personality, represents the crucifying, or wiping of personality out of consciousness. This is something that you will do. We deny the human self, so that we may unite with the selfless. We give up the mortal, so that we may attain the immortal. We dissolve the thought of the physical body, so that we may realize the spiritual body. The crucifixion of Christ. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God Atum Re, and the Word was God, creative power. The Word of God Atum Re, is the divine Word, God in His capacity, as creative power, Elohim in Hebrew, and includes all the potentialities of being. It is the idea of God, the image and likeness of God, the spiritual man, the Christ consciousness, and the Isar man. In the Word are all the possibilities, all the qualities of God. It is this Word of God, it is the spirit man, the idea of God, and the image and likeness of God, that the enemy of righteousness has crucified in you. The spiritual man, or Christ Hebrew man, the Word of God, is the true inner self of every individual. Man, therefore, contains within himself the capacities of being, and through his words, uses the creative principle of divine mind to create. The ancient Ethiopian Orthodox Christian Church says that the first chapter of John refers directly to Christ, which from the sons of Sananda's gnosis is in total alignment, for Christ, or spirit man, is the Word, the Ujat, and the Son of God, divine thought, or word of divine mind, are interchangeable. Christ Michael or Hebrew, Tahuti. This is the knowledge of your true self, the Word in you, that the enemy wants to revise, and change, and create new age religions, and doctrines in you. This is the crucifixion, of the Word or Christ, the spirit man or woman. Crucifixion of the Christ or spirit man. The crucifixion of Jesus is a symbol of wiping out the personality. This crucifixion is performed by you, for you will bear your own cross. Question: isn't Jesus coming into the world to be crucified a basic Christian belief? Answer: yes, it is one of the fundamental beliefs of Trinitarian Christianity. In the canon story, Jesus, Jesus died on the cross, and shed his blood for the sake of granting forgiveness to human beings. In other words, Jesus had died on the cross as a sacrifice for our sins. Let us investigate this topic from the Bible and find out whether Jesus of the canon was literally sent to be crucified in the physical sense, or was Jesus the total personality crucified so that the Christ, or spirit man, could be elevated in consciousness. Let's look at the scripture. Here we see Peter and the two sons of Zebedee was with Jesus the Christ, before the elders of the people, and the chief priests came to take him to crucify him. Jesus is talking to Peter and the two sons of Zebedee in Matthew 26:38. Then saith he, Jesus the total personality unto them, My soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here, and watch with me. Then Jesus went a little further away from them, and prayed to God, as in Matthew 26:39, and he went a little farther, and fell on his face, as making tzilat, or salvat, and prayed, saying, O my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me, nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt. It is very clear from the above verse in Matthew 26:39. That Jesus, the physical, perfected man, the total personality, didn't want to die. In this verse, it is shown that Jesus, the total personality, was praying strongly. He repeated these prayers 3 times to have this death removed from him. This makes perfect sense because the ego, or total personality, wants to live and lead the divine self. Question: so you are saying the personality doesn't want to die? Answer: yes, when you are born, you come into this world developing your personality. This personal self, the unreal self, wants to live on forever, but it has a time limit during this physical, temporal stage of existence. It was sent into the world first, but it was also sent to die, so the real divine you could live. The God in you sent this aspect of you into the world, so you could sacrifice this aspect of yourself, so the Christ, or spirit man, may lead you and live in you. This ego personality aspect of you is not the Christ, spiritual man, or woman in you. This is why these verses in Matthew are in contradiction with the statement, "Was Jesus sent to be crucified?" Question: so how would you define this aspect of Jesus, or the perfected man? Answer: this aspect of Jesus' total personality is the sum total of characteristics that man has personalized as distinct of himself, independent of others or of divine principle. This aspect of all of us must be crucified. The story of Jesus' crucifixion in the canon is symbolic of our spiritual transformation. The statement, "I am in the world, but not of the world," is referring to our original essence or spiritual self. As metaphysicians, we use the word personality in contrast with the word individuality. Question: what is the difference between the two? Answer: individuality is the real, personality is the unreal, personality is the mortal, the part of us that is governed by the selfish motives of the natural man. Question: wasn't Jesus more than a natural man? Answer: yes, and you are too, but in the canon he walked this earth in human form, and he had a personality, which is a veil or mask worn by every man, that conceals the real spiritual I am. Jesus, the perfected man, shattered this mask and revealed himself as the Christ, the true man of God, something that we must all do. Question: so what does individuality mean? Answer: when we talk about individuality, we are talking about Jehovah, Yahweh, Yahuwah, who he, or ideal man, image and likeness of Elohim, creative mind. Amin Ra. Symbol of the mirror image of the divine creator. Question: so who or what is the personality? Answer: the personality is Adam, natural, cognitive sense man, man formed by Yahweh, I am, that, I am, and commanded to develop his individuality in Eden, an environment of all potential possibilities. Personality is what man seems to be when he thinks in his three-dimensional consciousness. Individuality is what he really is when he thinks in his unlimited spiritual consciousness. As the true Christ self emerges, personality decreases. The real self, the individuality, begins to express. He must increase, but I, the ego, must decrease, John 3:30. It was Jesus' ego, the personality that was sent to be crucified. It was the personality that hesitated and didn't want to be killed at all. So-called Christian scholars tell us that this hesitation comes from the flesh side of him. In other words, he was tempted, and that his soul, which is godly, does not have this hesitation at all. But when we look at Matthew 26:38, it seems like Jesus is contradicting this idea by saying, "My soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even unto death." This is the animal soul, nefesh habehamet, which is the part of the soul that gives life to the physical aspect of man, the physical body, and is the source of animalistic desires within a person. Man has free will. In Matthew 26:38, he, the nefesh habehamet of Jesus, says that it really is his soul that is hesitating and not his body. These are Jesus' own words. God answered the prayers of Jesus. After Jesus made the above-mentioned prayer, he was answered by God, according to Hebrews 5:7, who in the days of his flesh, mortal consciousness, when he had offered up prayers and supplications with strong crying and tears unto him that was able to save him from death, and was heard in that he feared. These words clearly show that when Jesus, the ego personality, who was thinking in his mortal consciousness, or days of his flesh, was praying strongly to God, God would grant him his request. The word, "heard in that he feared," Hebrews 5:7, means that God granted him what he requested. So, the above verse shows that when Jesus, in the canon, asked of God to let this cup, the consciousness of eternal life, pass from him, Matthew 26:39, God responded to his prayer and saved him from physical death. Question: this doesn't make any sense. Then why was Jesus sent into the world to be crucified, if in the end he was saved from death? Answer: the reason it doesn't make sense is because it is the ego talking, and it is not to be taken literally, and it is talking about principles in man that has been hidden in a story. Even some of the verses of the Synoptic Gospels contradict themselves as absolute truth. We must extract and understand the symbols and principles in the story and not focus on the story itself. Question: are you saying there are contradictions in the Bible? Answer: yes, there are many contradictions in the Bible, many lost words, and many revisions and mistranslations. But if you focus on the meaning of the symbols in the story, and not the details of the story itself, the symbols will reveal the hidden truth within. Remember, in ancient Kemet we used symbols to tell our story. Here are some examples of contradictions from the canonized scriptures. Mark 16:5, who moved the stone? 5. Entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting at the right, wearing a white robe, and they were amazed. 6. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed, you are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who has been crucified. He has risen, he is not here, behold, here is the place where they laid him." Luke 24:3. 3. And they entered in, and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. 4. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. 5. And as they were afraid, and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, "Why seek ye the living among the dead?" 6. He is not here, but is risen. Matthew 28:2. 2. And, behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven, and came and rolled back the stone from the door, and sat upon it. 3. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. 4. And for fear of him the keepers did shake, and became as dead men. 5. And the angel answered and said unto the women, "Fear not ye, for I will know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. 6. He is not here, for he is risen." In Mark's Gospel, Mark 16:5, it was a young man sitting at the right, wearing a white robe. In Luke's Gospel, Luke 24:3, two men came and stood by the disciples. And Matthew tells us in Matthew 28:2, that there was a great earthquake, and the angel of the Lord descended from heaven, and came, and rolled back the stone from the door, and sat upon it. These are all clear contradictions between each witness to the event. The reason most people can't see the contradictions, and many refuse to see them, is because most people are spiritually asleep, and under a gospel, or ghost spell. Jesus' last words. Matthew 27:46 50, and about the ninth hour Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani?" That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Jesus, when he cried again with a loud voice, yielded up the ghost. Luke 23:46, and when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, "Father, unto thy hands I commend my spirit," and having said thus, he gave up the ghost. John 19:30, when Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished," and he bowed his head, and gave up the ghost. These accounts should be the same, but now do you see why we have to focus on the symbols and principles, and not on the story itself? Question: so the story of Jesus the ego personality was sent into the world to be crucified, so the Christ man, or divine spiritual man, can live in us, am I right? Answer: yes, you have it. Just study and meditate on the symbols, meanings, and principles, and the gnosis will come to you. Remember, the life of Jesus is a story of the crucifixion of the ego-sensed man, and the resurrection of the divine spiritual man in you. This story has been told for thousands of years in many cultures. It can be found in the story of Heru and Set of ancient Kemet, Egypt. There are at least 20 Christ-type stories that precede the modern canonized Jesus Christ story, which laid the foundation for the salvation of the world, and ascended back to heaven. Crucifixion of Christ types that predate the modern canon is story of Jesus Christ. Adad, of Assyria. Adonis, son of the Virgin Io of Greece. Alcides, of Thebes. Aedes, of Phrygia. Baal, and Tot, the only begotten of God, of Phoenicia. Bali, of Afghanistan. Bedru, of Japan. Buddha, Sakya, of India. Cadmus, of Greece. Crite, of Chaldea. Deva, Tat, and Samanakadam, of Siam. Divine Teacher, of Plato. Fohi, and Tun, of China. Gentuao, T. and Quetzalcoatl, of Mexico. Hissus, of Eros, and Brimrilla, of the Druids. Hill, and Feta, of the Mandates. Iski, of the island of Formosa. Ixion, and Quirinus, of Rome. Holy One, of Zeka. Indra, of Tibet. Jiao, of Nepal. Krishna, of Hindustan. Mikado, of the Sintus. Odin, of the Scandinavians. Prometheus, of Caucasus. Salivahana, of Bermuda. Thammuz, of Syria. Thor, son of Odin, of the Gulls. Universal Monarch, of the Sibyls. Widaba, of the Bilingonis. Zanalxis, of Thrace. Zor, of the Boneses. Zoroaster, and Mithra, of Persia. Zulus, or Sehul, also Osiris, and Horus, of Egypt. Question: so you are saying there were many stories of spiritual men being crucified in many cultures? Answer: in the ancient world, knowledge was given to the people in lesser mysteries, or myths, and parables, so the people at all levels could understand the meanings behind the symbols, usually using nature as its backdrop. These stories from all around the world were symbolic in principle of crucifying the personality of the total ego. Take up your cross and crucify the ego personality, the true meaning behind the myth. Take up your own cross. Matthew 16:24 to 28:24. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone wishes to come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me." 25. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. 26. For what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and forfeits his soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? 27. For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and will then repay every man according to his deeds. 28. Truly, I say to you, there are some of those who are standing here who will not taste death until they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Beginning. Hotep. This audiobook is one in a series on the true meanings of symbols in scriptural language, from books by Faheem Judah-EL. For more information on audio and printed books by Faheem Judah-EL, write to him at faheemjudahl@gmail.com.